call this channel Stop the Rust, because that's exactly what I'm going to do. And if the rumours on the internet are true, I can do it with cheap white vinegar. You know, I have small doubts, I have little scepticism, I do think it could fail. I'm going to do a comparison. I've got this piece of factory 40-year-old General Motors steel, and very sad story why it's in little pieces, but we're going to use it to do a comparison. Like, we're going to compare white vinegar with deoxidine, which is in fact phosphoric acid, an unknown mag wheel cleaner that's already diluted, and I really should test it with water, but I guess I'll compare these three and see the results from that first. Now, the rumours about white vinegar cleaning rust off your panel are, the rumour is combine it with Scotch-Brite and magically the white vinegar removes rust. Now, this kind of shits me just to hear this. It insults my intelligence, actually, because Scotch-Brite is really abrasive. This is this fine stuff, and this will remove paint and rust. This combined with fresh air, it removes rust. This combined with water removes rust. It's also an exfoliant and can keep your skin looking young. But for the sake of testing the chemicals, I'm not going to use any Scotch-Brite. I have a collection of cheap brushes. Yeah, I want this cheap crap to perform, not just on my fish and chips. So, I'm going to be generous. There we are. Vinegar. Now you this shit's expensive. Hope someone likes this video, because I got a lot of rust. I really need this shit. Phosphoric acid rust remover and metal conditioner. Corrosive liquids, poisons, NOS, contains ethylene glycol, monobutyl ether, 90 grams per litre, and phosphoric acids, 220 grams per litre, which I believe would be the main active ingredient. Dilute one part deoxidine with two parts water. Brush or swab this solution onto the surface and scrub thoroughly. Work in small areas using abrasive pad on stubborn rust spots. While still wet, wipe with damp cloth. R, clean rags. It's meant to say all clean rags, but it's just an R. Okay. There's also a whacker on the internet somewhere that says you should soak your panels in molasses. I'd like that to work too. I may give that a try. Now, unknown mag wheel cleaner. I'll save a piece of steel for this consumer quality rust converter too, and I'm a little skeptical on this too. Easy to use, non-toxic? I'm not going to test that. Converts rust and primes in one application. No washing down. Does not contain phosphoric acid. I'm a little disappointed it doesn't contain phosphoric acid. I've used phosphoric acid for a very long time, and you see results. Don't accuse me of cheating when I shorten this video. Unless you're willing to sit through the half an hour of this I'm going to be doing. Kind of reminds me of the Karate Kid. Wax on, wax off. That's time. Dude, it just kind of looks like it's cleaned it. Go. Yeah. Deoxidine. Different instructions and different bottles of phosphoric acid actually tell you to do different things, and it is confusing. Maybe the jury's out, maybe the science is incomplete. Maybe there's a right way, there's a wrong way. Leave a comment. I came to like wiping with an ever so slightly damp cloth when you're finished, but a cloth that was also quite dirty with phosphoric acid. And I liked putting heat on the panel to make sure, like, you scrub it, you wipe it dry, and then you heat it dry, because it's very bare, that metal, and it can rust right before your eyes from the dampness in the air. Wax on, wax off. I feel the zen flowing through me, all that chi power. And I wish it was a car. I wish it was my Chevelle and not this little scrappy shitty off car. Next experiment, what does phosphoric acid do to your phone? Mag wheel cleaner. I don't know what's in it. Okay, it's really not. Actually, it looks a lot less effective than the vinegar. I'm gonna have to try water. Okay, water and a soft brush. Yeah, obviously it's not going to restore your car, but it will tell me just how effective these other chemicals were. It'll give me a comparison. It'll give me, say, a zero on the scale. Let's figure out what zero is. This is worse than sex when you've got a headache. Hallelujah! So here's our results. This was the cheap white vinegar. I'm glad to say it was somewhat effective, and I'm going to be using this on my next project. This is the deoxidine. Outstanding, fantastic. We've proven it moves rust on its own without abrasive. Here's the mag wheel cleaner. I'd say don't even bother looking for any alternatives between these two. We have what we need. And this is the water, and I scrubbed very hard, and that's why it seems to have moved more than the mag wheel cleaner. But then my favourite, my best technique, and this is my secret, I think this is the best thing you can do, is you get a wire brush. This is designed to fit a grinder. You can also fit it to a paint polishing buff. Then you get your speed down a minimum. And that way you can get so much more scrubbing out of this than you ever could do by hand. And it's the slow speed that stops you from drying out the acid, because you need a washing effect from the acid. You need to rinse out that oxidized material and circulate fresh acid into the rust. And this is the best way that I know of to like get that rust out of those deep pits. And you really, it is possible. It still takes hours, but good luck. Go stop the rust.